Thank you to our friends from Western Maryland who are here today and made the trek to be here. This fight, first and foremost, belongs to them. Fracking is an issue that affects our entire state, but our Western Maryland friends, it's really up close and personal. Their courage to stand up and be heard in their communities and to say no and take the long view has really been what has led us through the wilderness on this issue, and they are my heroes on this fight. If Maryland is going to be different, if we are not going to be another Pennsylvania, Ohio, and West Virginia, it's going to be because of the people here in this room. And we aren't going to have the most money in this fight. Halliburton and Enerplus and Chevron are always going to have deeper pockets than us. They are always going to outspend us. They are always going to be the ones with the special interest lobbyists in the back room. But we've got you. And that matters. Because we're going to have your tenacity and your determination. We have your voices and your votes. We have your dedication and your commitment. And I can't thank you enough for engaging with us in this fight, because this is how we are going to take on big issues in Maryland. In Western Maryland, the economy and the environment are as tied together as a canoe and a paddle. And we can see the warning signs and the risks. Only now we have the opportunity to act first. We have the opportunity to act first. We have the chance to make sure that Maryland does not repeat the mistakes of our neighboring states. We will not drill first and ask questions later. We know that second chances are expensive and that we have to get it right the first time. Well-financed gas companies are knocking on our door and they're ready to push the gas pedal. And thankfully, for the last 2 years, we've been able to stop them. But will that hold? 2 years ago, I sat down and read an article in the Baltimore Sun by a gas industry scientist who said Maryland had vast economic potential locked under our mountains and streams, miles and miles below. He said once Maryland got into the fracking game, the jobs and the cheap energy would flow and all of our problems would be gone. Of course, he made no mention of flammable tap water or fatal well blowouts. The way he talked about trading Maryland's natural resources for economic gain with no consideration given to the impact on our environment or communities was frightening. And I also learned that Western Maryland already had been leased for drilling. 150,000 acres had already been leased, as a matter of fact, and there were 5 permits sitting on the desk of a regulator in Annapolis waiting to be approved. And yet, none of my colleagues and almost no one in Annapolis even knew what Marcellus Shale was at the time. So I thought, whew, we'd better get to educating some folks on this. I wrote an op-ed that appeared in an editorial that appeared in the Baltimore Sun, highlighting my concerns and calling on Maryland to slow down, take a time out on fracking until we had more information about whether it could be done safely. And in less than a week, I was out in Friendship, Maryland in Garrett County, meeting with Eric Robeson, Smokey Stanton, Paul Roberts, Nadine Gravania, and other Western Marylanders who were desperate for anyone outside of Garrett County to notice the fracking steamroller headed straight for the land that they so dearly loved. Garrett's growing ecotourism industry relies on fresh air and clean